Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to Profit Ada. So today exactly I'm gonna talk about this Excel. Previously I shown you how exactly you can go with your Excel updating the real time prices, stock prices. Okay, for you can watch this video. Okay, so I've been explained very nice and good manner in this video. So you just visit this video, so it will be helpful, very much helpful. Especially it will show you how you can create the book and how you can read the sheets, read and write. Okay, so please visit this real-time stock prices update with in Excel with Python. Okay, so this is one continuation. Okay, we definitely gonna use this Excel wings, and we will do some stuff and in these things we will definitely gonna talk about this conditional formatting and conditional statements, especially conditional statements. And then exactly we'll talk about this whenever you watch this Excel, especially you just go with color change stuff. Okay, so whenever you like the signal is there, if you just put some conditions, you will get a buy and sell. Okay, so I'm going to show you how you can have this signal, say some of the conditions matched and you got this buy and sell. Especially two things you can utilize for Excel. Say you are very much expert in Excel. Okay, so what happens, you can power up with the help of Python, and then what happens, you can go ahead and can utilize for your analysis purpose. You can watch in real time what exactly my OHLC data, you used to go in the terminal and used to check this OHLC and your technical indicators, whatever is there, used to watch and used to get the signals. So at a time if you visit any type of a websites, they're definitely going to show you a lot of stuff, charts, each and everything. So maybe if you are expert in Excel, you can do a lot of stuff. Okay, so here we are doing each and everything in the Python itself. And I must say that if you are really good in Excel, you know that how I should exactly format these things. And for this, for automating the Excel, this Python helps very well. As a Visual Basic is the main programming language for this Excel, but in this Python we can do a lot of stuff. We can integrate to Excel and can power up our Excel and can do a lot of stuff in visualizations or trading. Okay, so follow this video, it will be very much helpful. I definitely gonna put it in my I button, so you can go and if possible you can visit youtube.com/profitdata/videos and can watch this stuff. Okay, so it is one of the best thing. Okay, so go for it. So I've been showing you how you can update the prices as well. Right now I'll show you how you can go for the conditional statements. Okay, so if you go with if, else, if, each and everything. Okay, so you just go with if you are expert in Excel, you know. Okay, so I'll just show you in a right way. So this is my Excel, which is price.xlx. okay, and there you can feed whatever you want. Okay, and then I'll show you the formula with this help of formula tab and formula, how you can do in a short format. And I'm going to show you how you can do the color changes. So first of all, I just put some we will try to read. Okay, so we will say as an import Excel wings as XW. Okay, this is the main requirement. Okay, we will definitely gonna read from this and then we will gonna proceed. So okay, so we say XW equals, so whatever I got my book from this one. Okay, so what I say, W workbook equals XW. Okay, Excel wings, whatever book is there, my Excel. Okay, my this my name of Excel, which is how to store them. Okay, so which I have been shown my video. So in that video the depth is there. Okay, explained each and everything. Right now we are just doing an extension part. Okay, so go for it. In I button also there will be recommendation, they will be there, so scroll it and watch them in right side of your videos which you watch, it will be there. Okay, so that is also you can watch, and you from this also you can straight away can continue. Okay, so I talk about my sheet here. So I will say sheet equals. Okay, so whatever I got, workbook from that, I need to read these sheets, and it is very much simple. If you save any sheet, there will be a default name will be there, sheet one. Okay, so you have to say sheet one. That's it. You are ready to read whatever the value is there. Okay, so I was just talking about how you can do formatting. So suppose, like, if you are going with the strategy, OHL intraday strategy, and you want to know this stocks, this particular stocks is in buy or sell or something. Okay, so open equals high, we will go for the sell, and same wise. So we just go with a simple format. We'll go with the Tata Motors. Okay, and we will go with the price, with the open price. Okay, in which open and high we will go. If we high is, sometimes is there high, and we will talk about low also. Okay, so this is what happens. Okay, so I'm just gonna show for the open equals high. Then in between also, if you are going with some some other stuff, that is also good. So you can do it in Excel if you are good in this format. Okay, so I won't go much further in these things. Okay, but you can do a lot of stuff in Python as well. You know, required to come here and do it. You can place the formula and just store it there. Okay, in a string format, and it will do the same work. Okay, so I'm just showing you how you can do. So suppose if you are an Excel expert, it will definitely gonna help you. Okay, so you just need an if statements. If statement I'm going, and what is our, what happens, B1 equals C1. So if our B1 equals C1, then what happens, we'll go for for the cell. Okay, and if it is not, then what we will gonna do is like nothing. Okay, so we'll do nothing if it is there. Okay, we will wait for another symbol or something like that. Okay, so that is also you can say, or otherwise if it is like particular thing is there, if it is like this price or whatever open equivalence to 99, then you can go for buy as well. I mean, this is the way you can go. Okay, so it is vice versa. Open equals sell, you go for buy. Open equals high, you go for sell. So this is the way you can go. So right now what happens, B1 C1, easily you can read, this is B1, this is C1. Okay, and after that, what do you say, if not sell, then go for the buy. Okay, but that is very much different, or otherwise you can say nothing. Okay, so this is the way you can put anything. Okay, close this bracket, so it is good here. Okay, so right now it is sell, because open equals high, so it is given for sell. And if we like go something else, it will be different apart from that one. But we will definitely gonna see conditional statement is done here. Okay, so we are already in cell, so we'll do nothing. We will, like, right now we will check for our another condition for these things. Okay, we will go for another Tata Motors. Okay, and if 100 rupees is there, and say open equals this will be like say 102, but our low is equals 100. Okay, so same formula we will go it, we'll pick up here each and everything. Okay, and we will put it here. Sorry for this, you have to, whenever you are doing, okay, you have to press and enter, so it will work. So paste it here, but in between B equals not C1, it should be D1, and it should not sell, it is buy. Okay, So if we enter, okay, sorry, I think it's a B1, C1, and D1. White gives nothing. My B1. Sorry, it's not B1. It's a very much different. Okay. So it's a B2 equals D2. Okay, so you can, from with the help of Python also, you can go for the autofill. Okay, so right now we will talk about this color chain. So this is our sell and buy. Okay, so this is the way you can put in Excel, and if you are good in Excel, you know how to do other things as well. Okay, so right now I'll go to the Python and I'm ready to read this thing. Okay, so we will check at you know, range. First of all, we will go for the, you know, color. Okay, so if I go with the color sheet 1 dot range. Okay, so if I go with the range, mainly this is my, you know, E1 and E2. So this is my E1 and E2. So first of all, I should get the value. Okay, so if I say that you know, E1, okay, and any of the format which you go for this one, okay, E1, and color for what I say is like color for our E1, color E1, we will go for this way. Okay, you can, like, you know, go with the for loop also, that is also here. So if I'll go with the E1, then we will talk about this value, and if I get the value, then we will go for the, you know, formatting. So say I'll print whatever I get here. So color E1, what is color E1? Give me the value. Okay, so I have to conditional and color change, so I will say CC. Okay, so we'll print. So it will be like okay, maybe price. I think I'm missing something, so that's why it's unable to read price dot XLS. Oh, sorry, so it's not sheet 1 or something, it's just a sheet. Okay, so I think this is the way I can get. Okay, so we got cell, and one more thing is there, like, you know, range. When you are getting this range, we will talk about the color E2. So if you go for the E2, it should be something else. Okay, so color E2. So you can check in between this color also. Okay, so what is my color, and that the way you can change. So if I say E2, it should be like, you know, buy. Okay, so this is the way you can read. So now next we will proceed with our color change. So right now what happens, you got this value, okay, but you need to format them with your buy and sell. Okay, but right now you just can't, with the, you know, just give it the value or something like that and produce the color, it won't happen. Okay, so you can say that if this color means like E1, if it contains cell, then go for cell. Or same thing if it is like you know, if it has buy or something. So this is the way you can go. Okay, so instead of E1, E2, I've just shown you how you can go, but in another format you can utilize this way. Okay, so what happens if my color E1 equals cell? Okay, then what happens, I'll go for formatting the sheet in you know, especially red color. So you know, just I just don't take this value, only I need the range and sheet. Okay, so with this way I can say, and I have to format through this API dot font dot. So this is the way. There is another you know, so much you know, formats are there which won't work for this color index. So this is the way you have to go, and you have to say 3 or say 4. Okay, so this is the way you can change. So already cell is there, so we'll try with the index 4 and see what happens. So our price XLX. Okay, so as you can see, if 4 is there, it is cell. Okay, and if we'll like you know, same way we'll go for our E2 as well, color E2. So now we will go for the buy. Okay, so if it is buy, then what happens for the E2? We need to change as a 3. Okay, so you know, if we go through this one, so what happens? This is the way it will get work. Okay, so buy is there for E2, color index. Oh, sorry, so this should be E2, then only it recognize. And so that's the way you can change. So I think first of all, index 3 is green, and for 4 you should go for red. Okay, so if we do this, we know exactly what happens. Okay, so for our cell it is red, and for buy it is green. So this is the way you can go. So you can check you know, other color as well. Okay, so if you put 1 and 2, there will be black and white. Okay, which you can go. Okay, so black and white. Okay, so white you can see. So this is the way you can do the color changes. But we only required for right now, we'll go for black and red also, formatting with that one. And in between, like you know, for this thing, you know, other color changes as also you can go, but mainly we will use for our buy and sell, you know, this green and red. So we'll go for this thing. Okay, so you know, you can utilize. So 3 is for the red, and green for the buy. Okay, so for this you can refer for the Excel wings. Okay, so mainly I think for color changing I'm not worried about. Okay, so this is the only thing, is like, you know, you can just check with the index whatever you feel like, just go with it. So right now I must say that whatever you got the color index, mainly 3 and 4, which exactly required this green and red is mainly what required. So we'll go with this thing, that's it. And try with these things. If any color you require, just go with it. Okay, so you just have to give this color index and you have to follow this format. Okay, so go for it, try this stuff. And this conditional formatting, whatever if and else statements, can be done in your Python as well, but it should contain the same format. Okay, it should go this way in Excel. Okay, so I prefer that you know, if you are very much expert, you can power up through Excel and try to go with these things. Okay, so see through these things and try to work it out for yourself. In previous video I've been shown how you can, like you know, go for your life price. So there you will get the life price, and if you do life price, what happens, you know, if you put a loop, and then if you go for these things, color change you will get, and in between conditional statement also will be there, and you just go with autofill and so many things you can go with. Go with the Excel, you can do a lot of stuff. So try this stuff and try to learn step by step. And yeah, thanks for watching. Please do like, share and subscribe. If you got any doubt regarding this video, please do comment below. If you have any other queries or requirements, please do contact me direct via WhatsApp. Thank you.